Xbox has had a troubled console generation twice in a row, and now they have to fully change their strategy on how they'll reach gamers across multiple devices. But Xbox is promising to launch next generation consoles soon with the most advanced and unconventional console ever made. And the best part, it might have more games than any other console in history. This is Colt Eastwood. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about the new next generation console and how it's going to change everything. If you end up enjoying this video, let me know by liking and subscribing to the channel. Hit the bell to be notified of new content, and let's talk about Xbox in 2026. The past two Xbox console generations have been plagued with passable power and performance and the long wait for games. This has lowered the ability for Xbox to push sales enough in the console market. So it's surprising to hear that Microsoft is allowing Xbox to start another console generation, and it could start as early as 2026 or 2027. Rumors of a two-device approach, a handheld and a traditional console box, have surfaced amongst insiders and games media journalists who have been talking to hardware sources, even with Xbox's own Phil Spencer basically telling IGN that Xbox will have their own handheld soon. There is something so shockingly unexpected and industry game-changing with the new Xbox console plan that will show why this new Xbox console is so unique. Xbox is secretly working on a universal Xbox dashboard that will unify the interface and the whole Xbox experience across any device that is supported by the Xbox kernel and Windows platforms. This means that anyone with a gaming PC rig now or into the future could download and install the entire Xbox dashboard on their desktop PC, laptop, or even new handhelds. And this is integral to what Xbox is doing with their next console. But why would Xbox want their experience, their dashboard, and their ecosystem with their games available on any device that is not just an Xbox console? This would cannibalize the opportunity for people to buy a new Xbox. And all of this would make it possible for gaining new Xbox customers, but the new console wouldn't just be a traditional Xbox console. Rumors have been circulating that the Microsoft Surface team has partnered with the Xbox hardware team to build a console Windows hybrid set-top device, a set-top Xbox console that shares the latest Windows but also has the entire Xbox dashboard experience, which of course brings forward all of the games that are available on the Xbox Series right now, which includes backward-compatible Xbox original games, Xbox 360, and Xbox One titles. And since this new Xbox console hybrid is fully based on the current version of Windows, it will also be able to natively install Steam, Epic, GOG, Ubisoft, EA, and much more to give you access to any and all of the games you want to own or play on PC. But those games will be fully playable on the Xbox console and its new hardware. This would be the first console in history to offer more games than have ever been offered before, with some 6,000 Xbox titles that are now available on the current Xbox and the millions of games that are across all of the PC platforms as long as you are logged into those accounts. Right now, thanks to the popularity and success of PC gaming handhelds like the ROG Ally, Lenovo Go, and Steam Deck, PC versions of games are already able to detect the customized hardware in these handhelds and set the games to run accordingly with the software and their hardware. This means that with just a few adjustments, the Xbox console hybrid could play native PC games on Steam through their interface and their storefront, utilizing whatever power is built into the next Xbox console. All of your Xbox console titles, plus PC games using the hardware and the performance, you would get the full new universal Xbox dashboard set to run across Xbox-supported devices on this new Xbox hybrid console, with Windows built underneath, which means you also get a conventional gaming PC. Of course, native Xbox console versions of games would be developed utilizing new features for the performance, which for the first time ever will have a silicon-based AI upscaling and frame rate boost set for performance. As for the hardware and capabilities, the new next-gen Xbox may not specifically prioritize raw power and instead be the first video game console built with key AI integration in mind. Microsoft has invested tremendous amounts of money into AI, and its Copilot tech is helping revolutionize productivity, and OEMs are teasing AI-based PCs, and AI chips are in high demand. Right now, you can get games that will produce extra frames and upscale resolution in games to make them look and feel better, even as games get more demanding. The possibility of having onboard AI accelerators, potentially the NPU or Neural Processing Unit coprocessors that work alongside the highly customized chipset, leaks from Microsoft suggests that they could utilize the ARM64 CPU instead of X64 CPU. The reason for this choice may be made with AI in mind, meaning that Xbox could go with ARM architecture over the regular AMD that they've been using for their consoles over the past several decades. Another big reason why Microsoft would select this kind of chip is because of cloud compute. ARM is better suited for this kind of integration for boosting performance and getting games looking sharper. Microsoft could leverage AI and cloud tech to streamline various processes, most importantly, the frame rate interpolation that modern TVs already do, but those introduce so much latency behind the controls, it isn't really viable for gaming. But frame rate interpolation in the silicon and with hardware support, AI-powered frame rate prediction would allow lower spec hardware like this Xbox hybrid console compared to big gaming PCs to run high-quality games at 60 FPS and beyond. Especially since advanced Unreal Engine tech and realistic graphics are so demanding on modern hardware right now. The concept of having a new unconventional Xbox that is also a PC hybrid with literally millions of games available. The most choice and most value bringing this experience to all gamers is a game changer. Providing gamers with a conventional console box for their TV with the most powerful hardware that's also boosted by AI generative performance, all on what will probably become the new gaming standard, being able to play your games however you want. The next Xbox will likely guide the games industry with more choice, and this all could start as soon as 2026. This is Colt Eastwood. Thank you so much for checking out this video. If you got anything from what we discussed, it is that the next Xbox console is also going to be a PC. That's pretty much what I think is going to happen. And unlike anything else, your PC can play millions and millions of games. One thing it can't play is a digital library of over 6,000 games you can buy right now or that you already own and you can play. There are so many games in backward compatibility that are only available thanks to Xbox's backcompat program. So it makes this incredible universal system where you could take that experience, whether it be on just a regular Xbox console, across PC, handhelds, the cloud, and so much more. It's really going to be interesting, and I think it'll push the industry to open up and allow their games to be played in more ways. Now, I think that Nintendo and PlayStation will take a while to get to that point, but this is really what it's been about with Xbox and PC for over a decade. If you ended up enjoying this video, let me know by liking and subscribing to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of new weekly content. If you want to further support the Colt Eastwood channel, you can do that by hitting the join button below. And that will get you early access for videos some 12 hours before they go up. It'll get you giveaways that we do monthly for merch and so much more. Also, you can check out the Patreon. The channel membership and the Patreon get a lot of the same benefits, so you can join either way there if you want to help out. But I want you to also check out the X&C podcast. We do a weekly podcast every Monday, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. And there we'll talk about the gaming news breakdown, things that we hear, sources and leaks and speculation. And it's a really good show. And I'm there with Middle-Aged Game Guy, and we bring in guests occasionally. That's a good show. That's also available on Spotify, Google, and Apple Podcasts on demand after the point if you want to check out that show. But I want to know what you think about the Xbox console, this hybrid, this Windows / Xbox PC box. And I know you can just buy a PC, but think about it. Xbox is going to provide this pretty performative box for about $600, maybe $700, probably $600 in the US, and you'll get access to millions of games. And I wonder if it will truly get them to compete in the market. And that's what we really need. I want to know what your opinion is in the comment section. And while you're there, as I always say, please be nice.